first, the gerontologists, which is people that study aging in America, in the West, they've come to the conclusion that after the age of 40, 75% of your well-being and longevity comes from your lifestyle, not from your genes. So the genetics are only 25%. Now, there's another piece to it, is what we call epigenetic programming. Yeah. Now, the epigenetic programming is what, in a sense, is the protein coding around the genes that turns the genes on or off. It's like a protein coding over the actual physical genes. It's like a coding that's affected by the environment, by affected by the herbs, affected by what you're taking and how you're living. For example, research showed in 2001 that when they underfed rats by 40%, there was a 400% increase in turning on the anti-aging genes, the anti-cancer genes, the antioxidant genes, okay, and anti-inflammation genes, simply by decreasing your diet by 40%. That was an epigenetic phenomena that turned on the anti-aging genes. When we fast for a week or so, we're turning on the anti-aging genes and other genes that make you healthier. That's actually what's happening. When I see people hearing of their blood pressure in 1 week, which is like 90% of the people, it's clearly we've turned on the anti, you know, the healthy blood pressure genes epigenetically. We've switched, and the fasting does that. So they all play. So you want to live and eat and sleep in a way that's going to best turn on your epigenetic, healthy epigenetic longevity genes. That's the name of the story. So that should answer it. I think that's pretty complete. So we can't just say take an herb and do whatever else you want to do. It's a commitment of wisdom and character, midot, values, lifestyle. All those impact your genes, including what you take. We're going to be talking about resveratrol, which is very specific for turning on anti-aging genes, and particularly the serotonin gene complex, which creates an anti-aging effect. So you see that it's a little, everything's interactive. So the higher you do it globally, the better everything is.